You have your Bibles, please open it with me in Psalms chapter 33. We will be reading from verses 4 to 11. Psalms 33, 4 to 11. The words of the Lord are true, and all his works are dependable. The Lord loves what is righteous and just. His constant love fills the earth. The Lord created the heavens by his command, the sun, moon, and stars by his spoken word. He gathered all the seas into one place. He shut up the ocean depths in storerooms. Worship the Lord, all the earth. Honor him, all peoples of the world. When he spoke, the world was created. At his command, everything appeared. The Lord frustrates the purposes of the nations. He keeps them from carrying out his plans. But his plans endure forever. His purposes last eternity, eternally. God bless the reading of his word. Praise the Lord. Let's all be seated.
Praise God. Good morning once again. Hallelujah. It's month of February, and the world, of course, even in the midst of this pandemic, but all we know that the world would celebrate this Valentine's or this month of the heart. And so with this, would like to invite all the church officers and ministers to join with us on February 15. That's Monday, for we will be having our a program now for husband and wife, and this is a wonderful experience for husband and wife, for ministers and officers. So please don't hesitate to join, and please see Sister Alma Lapad, and you may now register yourself. Sila na lang, mungutan na lang mo dito kung unsay mga dapat himuon. Mga daghan na, mga siguro mga 30 or 35 couples na ang nagparehistro. And we would invite all officers, both the elected and the appointed officers. And we were reminded about the prayer force. Thank you for joining. Unya, alang sa mga church officers, ingon sa Bible, nga we are accountable to the soul or to the blood of these people, nga wa ta mag-warning. And so our prayers would be a part of warning, that we will just keep them in our prayers or uphold them in our prayers, all the members of the church. And we will assure you that all church officers will be prayed for, ampuan kamo sa tanan ng mga ministers, and inviting all the members to pray for all the ministers. So ingana ang atong mga buluhaton. Okay? Until dunay himuon ang Dios nga dagkong himuon sa Dios diri sa atong isimbahan. And aside from that, we will be having our prayer and fasting this month, February 22 to 27. And it was then decided by all ministers nga nag-decide may nga every month, okay? Every month, we have 1 week prayer and fasting. Every month. Kada bulan, natay pagpuasa, isa ka semana, or maybe 5 to 6 days. And so, we would invite everyone to please join us. Like for instance, first Monday, will be handled by Pastor Loloy, unya sila ni Pastora Malo, sila si Pastora Flor, sila si Pastor Oge, Ruby, sila si Pastor Gangang, and many more. And kami ni Pastora Alice, mo'y muhandal sa culmination or sa Friday. So if you feel like joining on Monday, please join us. Tungod kay dako kinig kahimuan, alang ka natong tanan. Now aside from that, if you have some prayer requests, you can just text, ipaabot lang dito sa atong simbahan so that the secretary will just, pwede niya ipasa dito sa tanan ng mga officers so that they could include that prayer request nga mapasa dito sa ilaha, and they will be praying for you. Okay? Kung doon yung mga importante kayo nga dapat ampuan, don't be ashamed and don't hesitate to just text para maabot ang mga pag-ampo, ang prayer request, and that the church officers could pray for you. Okay? So thank you so much. And we were reminded that kinahanglan na tayo face mask. And I'm just sorry, kamo na lang mag-face mask din ha. Ako na lang mag-face shield din he. Bisag nagpamina mo, I would ask you to just put your face mask and I'll just use this face shield because I cannot breathe, no? It's hard for me to speak pagkatapos na itabon ang akong baba o akong ilong. So, kamo na lang itabon diha. Would it be okay? Okay ra ba siya? Dili ba ko dakpon diri sa Marshall? Oh, dakpon diri. Manguli na lang. Tawa na may magwali. Okay? So, we praise and thank God. Shall we pray? We are so thankful, Heavenly Father, for this wonderful day. And what a privilege, Lord, to be in your presence. Again, our desire is not only to enjoy your very presence, but we want more of you, and that is to listen to you. Father God, I pray that you would bless each one, even as we open our hearts, Lord, to you, and Lord, willing to accept and receive the word prepared, intended for us today. We also pray for those who are listening to radio, and even, Father God, for those who join with us through live streaming. God, I pray that you would bless them, and everyone inside of this building, even for those people outside, Lord, God, there is a campus, we just pray. Lord God, that you're not God of the distance. You can just touch, you can just minister to each one, Lord, even at a distance. We give you thanks and praise, even giving life to your words. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise God. Now, the book of Psalm 33, verses 4 to 11, money ang atong emphasis for the month of February, we will be talking about love, but it's not our love. I will be talking about the love of God. Gugma sa Ginoo, pag-ibig ng Diyos ang ating pag-usapan sa buong buwan ng February. Hindi yung pag-ibig natin, kundi pag-usapan natin ngayon ay ang pag-ibig ng Diyos. Okay? So, we praise and thank God for that. So, with this, I'd like to just bring to you the message entitled, The Unfailing Love of God. Kung sa Bisaya ni, ang dili mo pakyas nga gugma sa Diyos. Dili gid siya mo pakyas. Unfailing. Rain or shine, whatever happens in all circumstances or in all circumstances, the love of God is the same. Wala gid mausab. It's still the same. That love is unfailing. Now, if you would measure the love of God, or how would you measure the love of God? Unsaon imong pagsukod sa gugma sa Dios? Maybe you would say, oh, God really loves me when all things are good for me. He really loves me because everything is good. And you would probably magingon ka nga ang Dios na higugma kanako when everything is all right. Tanhan maayo. Moingon ta nga God really loves me. And when all situations na ang pabor sa Ginoo kanato. When all situations favor us. So with this mga pangutana, makaingon kita na God really loves me because of this. Everything is good. Oh, what a wonderful life. What a good life I have today. What a good life I have because He makes everything good for me. He makes all things good. He makes everything right for me. And all favors, He gave it to me. So, muna makaingon kita nga, God loves you. Or God loves me so much. But if, when all things are not good to you, can you just say, God loves you? When everything is not right, all is wrong, and situation does not favor you, can you just still say that God loves you? Of course, God loves us. Because the Bible says, the earth is full of His unfailing love. Now, there were times it would be easy for us to say, oh, pastor, okay lang. bisag dili maayo sa kuha, I can just say that really God really loves me. Now, kung dunay duha ka pasahero na lang na bilin, you need to ride. Kasi kinahanglan makasakay ka. Niya ikaw lang o katong isa. Pagkatapos, hindi ikaw ang napili. Katong isa ang napili. Unya, wato siya magdali. Hindi po siya nagmamadali. Ikaw ang nagmamadali. Ngayon, yung pabor hindi binigay sa iyo. Maybe you can question. Alright? Maybe you can question. I've been mentioned this morning, nga dili pabor sa imuha. Ikaw mismo ang nakakakita. Pinatay ang iyong magulang, pinatay ang iyong kapatid, kitang-kita mo. At pagkatapos ito'y dinala doon sa korte. Pagabot ito sa korte, dili kumplito ang ebidensya. Hindi kumplito yung ebidensya. At pagkatapos ng kaso, ang sabi ng judge, verdict ng judge, yung criminal na yon, not guilty. What will be your reaction? Kasi hindi nakapabor, hindi pabor para sa iyo. Kasi dapat precious siya. Kasi ikaw mismo nakakakita, pinatay niya ang mahal mo sa buhay. Kitang-kita mo't pinatay. Ngayon, hindi siya nabilanggo. Wala siya na preso. Dili nakapabor sa imuha. And you hated much. You cried much. You've been praying for this. The fact you sent prayer request to the church para dunay justisya. But there's no justice at all. What would be your reaction? Can you still say God loves you? Of course, God loves us. But sometimes as human as we are, we have a lot of reactions. Samot na dili pabor sa tua. And you've been there. You've been so faithful in the Lord. You've been prayed for this. Unya dili nahatag ang pabor sa imuha. And that's something. But brothers and sisters, I'd like to just encourage and remind you that in all situation, God loves you. Sa tanan sitwasyon, ang Diyos na higugma kanimo. Now, before sharing to you the proof and the reason why the reason of the unfailing love of God for us, in spite of everything, I'd like to share to you the statement of Adrian Rogers, usa ka alagad sa Dios. He said, "It is better to be divided by truth than to be divided in error." All right? Because what we want is for us to be good. Ang atong gusto mang good, when we measure the love of God, gusto nato nga yung gusto natin ang talagang matuman. But the statement of Adrian Rogers, he said, "It is better to be divided by truth than divided by errors." So kung doon ay tinuod, let's divide. Kasi itong totoo eh. Kung ayaw mong tanggapin, ikaw bahala ka. Kaysa magkaisa tayo, tapos error itong dinadala, tapos andyan tayo sa pagkakamali. And the next statement he said, "It is better to speak the truth that hurts and then heals than falsehood that comforts and then kills." Okay? Bahala na sakit. Sabihin mo yung totoo. Masakit. Kasi totoo. Okay na yun. Because after all, may healing. At magkaisa din tayo. Kaysa nagkasamahan tayo na puro falsehood for more on words of comforts, pero hindi na totoo. But that kills you. Because nobody corrected you. So it's better to speak the truth that hurts you, that hurts me, than falsehood that comforts, and after that, it kills you, it kills me. Then the last statement he said, "It is better to be hated for telling the truth than to love for telling a lie." Bahala na masakitan ka sa kuha. Musulti ko sa tinuod. Masakitan man, masakitan. That would be okay. Kasi totoo. Kaysa magmahalan tayo for telling a lie. For a lie. Brothers and sisters, usahay masakitan ta. But that's the love of God. Dili gusto ang Dios nga masaktan, dili gusto ang Dios nga mamakakta. Kung anong totoo, sabihin mo yung totoo. Okay? Bahala na og somebody of people would hate you. But the thing is this, for telling the truth, done to be loved, and people would appreciate you. A lot of people would follow you. A lot of people would appreciate you because you tell a lie for you to be loved. Oh, bahala na lang. I will not accept it. I will tell the truth. That really breaks probably your heart because of the truth. But after all, you will be healed. So, when we are in a circle, kung kitang tanan na sa circle, with Jesus Christ inside, I'd like just to remind you that when Jesus Christ is inside of the circle, He will not leave the circle because you are there. Because we are there. Hindi tayo pababayaan ng Diyos sa loob ng circle kasi andyan siya, andyan tayo. Mahal tayo ng Diyos, hindi niya tayo pababayaan. Pwede sigurong ikaw ang lalabas sa circle. Pwede kang lalabas sa circle, pero ang Panginoon, si Jesus Christ, ay hindi at hindi talaga siya lalabas sa circle kasi mahal tayo ng Diyos. Pwedeng galit ka sa Kanya, pero ang Diyos, mahal Kanya. Hindi siya lalabas dyan, babantayan niya. Kung ikaw maggawas, why mahimo, pero naidaghan dito sa sulod na ginabantayan niya. The same as your pastor. When we are in the circle, I will not leave you. I will still be there because I love you. It might be pwede ka mugawas, pwede ka muhawa, but ako, naaragin ko din eh, that the moment you will come back, they will return. I am still inside of the circle. That's how I love the church. I need to protect the church. I need to protect the people inside the circle. I must be there. I must be there. So kung buto sabot, si Jesus wala muhawa, hindi umalis ang Panginoon, ikaw lang siguro ang umalis. Ikaw lang nagpalayo. No, the same as sa tua. Wala ko nagpalayo sa imuha. Maybe ikaw ang nagpalayo. Pero ako naarakod din eh. From the very start of the day, we're here. And just to love you and just to take care of this church. No, the same as with the Lord. Because of His unfailing love, He would not leave us. That's how He loves us so much. Now, in the book of Psalm 33, verse 5, being read to us, He loves righteousness and justice, and that the earth is full of His unfailing love. That was His statement. Duha ka butang gisgutan niya diha. First is justice. Justicia. If you would ask justice, sometimes in the world you cannot find justice, but even sometimes in the church you cannot find justice in the church. And sometimes even in our family we cannot find justice in the family. But remember this, God is justice. And so therefore, it must come from God. Not doesn't come from anyone. It really came from God. God is just. Ang kalibutan, pwede sigurong magbalik-baliktad. Tungod kay maayo siya sa imuha, then you would be good for Him. Maayo siya, unya nasin hatag sa imuha, you would be good for Him because there's a lot of things that He gave to you and you may be good to Him. Is it just? Bisag na imali? No, it's not just. But in the world, sometimes we cannot experience this justice, but God must be, the justice must come from God. On the part of the people, it must come from us keeping the commandments and showing God's love. Para dunay justisya, bahalag magkinaunsa ang dagan sa kinabuhi, justice will still remain. Na ang justisya. Pero kinahanglan, let's just continue to keep His commandments and share God's love for each one. That is justice. Now, righteousness, ikaduha. Might be people would just ingon sila nga, matuo man ka na, simba-simba, wamay, wana. Mo na istorya sa gawas. Pero dili inga na, mo istorya sa Dios. Righteousness does not earn from the appreciation of everyone. You cannot be righteous because somebody appreciated you. You cannot be righteous because somebody look at you are good. Righteousness can be earned from God, dili sa tao. And secondly, with a consistent walking or walk uprightly in the Lord. Kanang mapadiyunon nga naglakaw ka nga matarong o tinuod nga pagpangalaga di sa Dios, then righteousness will be enjoyed by you. Sometimes walay hustisya makita nato. Like for instance, I'd like just to just show to you. When Jesus Christ was brought by the soldiers dito sa throne ni Pontius Pilate, and because Pontius Pilate could not decide, so what he did, he called one of the worst criminal in Israel. His name is Barabbas. And Barabbas stood up, Jesus also stood up. And Pontius Pilate asked the people, kinsa inyong pilion nga ipagawas? Sinyong pipiliin para ipalabas? Sigaw ng mga tao, ipagawas si Barabbas. Ipagawas si Barabbas. Bakit si Barabbas? Drug lord? Mamamatay tao? Rapist? Bakit siyang ipalabas? Si Jesus na walang kasalanan? Bakit siya ipako sa cross? Look at that. What if ikaw yun? Yung masamang tao ang pinalabas, ikaw na walang kasalanan, yun ang ipapako sa cross. Mga kapatid, there's no justice sometimes, we think about it. But God has a purpose in everything that had happened. My point here is this. As mentioned, emphasis nato last month, that we want to be mature. Kailangan maintindihan nato, maintindihan natin lahat ng mga nangyayari sa buhay natin, either good or bad. Either good or bad. Kinahanglan masabtan nato ni siya pag-ayo. Doon ako'y nakita nga trailer o marabag silida. Nag-away, doon ay nag-away. Pagkatapos, gidunggab, sinaksak. Nung masaksak, tumakbo yung mga tao, tumakbo yung mga nakasaksak. At naiwan yung tao na nasaksak, almost dying. Dumating yung kaibigan. Pagtanaw niya, iyahang amigo. Paggunit niya, gikuha niya ang kutsilyo nga nakataob sa lawas, gikuha niya ang kutsilyo. It so happened, mo'y pag-abot sa pulis. And he was in prison for 20 years. Ikaw ka, ingana, what would be your reaction? Wala akong kasalanan. Where is justice? Wala akong kasalanan. For 20 years, people mocked you because you are a criminal when in fact you did not do it. Hindi mo nagawa. So where's the favor? Asa ang pabor sa tao? Dili sa imuha. Hindi sa iyo. Pero alam mo, wala kang kasalanan, pero walang pabor na inibigay sa iyo. Ang hirap isipin. But that's the reality of life. But I would like to tell you, brothers and sisters in the Lord, in everything that had happened, God has a purpose. You know what? For 20 years, he was in prison. He became born again in the cell. And when he went out, nakagawas siya, he became pastor. Look at that. Hindi natin paminsan maintindihan ang mga pangyayari sa buhay. But the only thing I know, God still loves us. Ang Diyos pa dayon na higugma kanato. Now I'd like to show to you a proof of his unfailing love. Ganun makaingon man ta, bakit masama ingon ta kita nga unfailing good ang iyang gugma. Verses 4, 6 to 9 sa Psalm 33. Ingon sa verse 4. For the word of the Lord is right and true. He is faithful in all he does. And in verse 6. By the word of the Lord were the heavens made, their starry host by the breath of his mouth. He gathers the water of the sea into the jars. He puts the deep into the storehouses. Praise God. And for he spoke, verse 9, it came to be. He commanded and it stood him. Igsoon, ngano kaingon man ko unfailing ang gugma sa Dios. Number one, because of the power of his word. The point is this. Ang gugma sa Ginoo, sani, walay katapusan. The love of God is unfailing. Why? Because of the power of His word, what I mean is, in other words, sinabi na niya. Dili na niya pwedeng bakwion kasi sinabi na niya na mahal ka ng Diyos. Hindi na niya pwedeng bawion. Giingnan ka niya, anak, mahal ta ka. To the fact, I sent my own son, my only begotten son, to die for you because I love you. Dili na pwede bakwion sa Ginoo kasi sinabi na niya. Amen? Gisulti na niya. Kaya magkinaon sa mananggagan sa imong kinabuhi, God loves you kasi sinabi na niya. Look, His word is right and true. You cannot deny it. Pag sinabi ng Diyos mahal ka niya, gagawin niya lahat. The fact I said, He sacrificed His only son because of His love for you. Hindi na niya pwedeng bawion. When Adam and Eve disobeyed the Lord, but yet, giapas pa gyud sa Ginoo si Adam and Eve because gisulti na niya. Nga gihigugma sa Dios ang kalibutan. For God so loved the world. And who are this? Kinsa man ang world? It's you and me. Secondly, by His word, everything was created. Pinaagi siya gisulti, nahimo ang tanan. Could you imagine that? Paghigugma pa sa imo, di niya mahimo. Sa isang salita niya, let there be light, let there be mountain. Everything was created by His word. Paghigugma sa imuha, tili na niya mabawi kasi sinabi na niya. Kaya anumang mangyayari sa buhay mo, ibutang sa imong unahuna, ibutang sa imong kasing-kasing, gihigugma ka sa Dios kasi sinabi na niya. Ambot kinsabi nagsaad sila mga asawa nga, dai gihigugma ta ka, o kabuto nako ang bituon sa langit, o akong ibutang sa imong ulo, o niya iprumpurong nako sa imo ha. Ana. Sinabi mo na kasi, kaya hindi mo na pwedeng bawiin, much more ang atong Ginoo. Kasi sabi ng Diyos, mahal ka niya, by the power of His word, He cannot deny it. He loves you so much. Thirdly, every word He said will come to pass. And sabi niya sa verse 9, for He spoke and it came to be. Pag sinabi ng Diyos, mangyayari talaga yon. Kaya pag sinabi ng Diyos, mahal ka niya, totoo yon. Amen? Pag ingon ng Diyos, gihigugma ka niya, bisan sa kalisod, sa dagan sa imong kinabuhi, and yami, sometimes you would question, oh, did God, mahal ba ako ng Diyos sa hirap ng buhay ko ngayon? Walang hustisya, bakit ganito ang takbo ng buhay ko? Mahal ba talaga ako ng Diyos? Kapatid, anumang mangyayari, mangyayari man ang mangyayari, mahal ka ng Diyos. Pag sinabi niya, totoo yun. Every word He said will come to pass. That's why I said, His love is unfailing because of His word. Because the power of His word, sinabi niya, kaya ako man, pag sinabi kong mahal kita, hindi ko na yan babawiin. Pag nagingon ko nga gihugog matagay, nakabawion, naarakod diri. I love you with the love of the Lord. I could not just take it back. What I said, when Jesus said, when God said, it really come to pass. So that's how God loves you. He loves you. It's unfailing. Why? Because of the power of His word. Gisulti na sa Ginoo nga gimahal ka niya. Bisag nga ni ang dagan sa akong sitwasyon sa akong kinabuhi, Pastor? Yes. Bisag nagkamali ko? Yes. Bisag nagkasala ko? Yes. Mahal ka pa rin ng Diyos. Kasi sinabi na niya eh. Nakita ba niyo how the Lord God loves you so much? He deserved a clap offering. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Oh, praise God. Thank you, Lord. Saad na niya. Secondly, in verse 5 and 11, ingon sa verse 5, sa kibasa na ito ganina, the Lord loves righteousness and justice. The earth is full of His unfailing love. Verse 11, the plans of the Lord stand firm forever, and the purposes of His heart through all generations. Iksoon, The love of God is unfailing first because of the power of His word. Sinabi na niya. Pangalawa, because of the plan, of His plan for the world. Because of His plan. Ibig sabihin, kasama ka, kasali ka, kasali ako sa plano ng Diyos. Pagkanindot, diyan. Sa wala pa ka na tao, doon na ay plano ang Ginoo sa imuha. Kasali ka na sa plano ng Diyos. Up to the next generation, kasali na. Kasali ka na doon. Mga igsuon, pagka matinud-anon ang gugma sa Ginoo, kanatuntanan. Ingana ta kamahal sa Diyos. Look, as a family, sa inyong pamilya, when you plan something, musuroy ta, asa man ta musuroy? Sa Dabao de Oro, magingon ang, ibig sabihin, sinong kasama natin? Aka nang isa ka anak, ayaw na lang na i-appel. Hindi pwede yun eh. Kasali ka, kasi pamilya ka, amen? Pamilya ka, kasali ka sa plano sa imong ginikanan. Muna nga, gani, wapa ka na tao, giandaman na ka sa imong ginikanan o glampin, kaniyan to. Kung lalaki man, nabalaan lalaki na ay blue. Kung babae, pink, giandaman na kaglampin. Kasi kasali na yan sa plano. Tulad ngayon, dahil mahal ka ng Diyos, kasali ka sa plano ng Diyos. Kauban ka sa plano sa Ginoo. You're not rejected. Bisan nga ng sitwasyon sa imong kinabuhi, ang daming problema sa sitwasyon sa imong kinabuhi karon, pagkalisod sa dagan sa imong kinabuhi, kasali ba ako sa plano ng Diyos? Yes. Kauban ka sa plano. Kasali ka sa plano sa Diyos. Ang living temple, kauban sa plano sa Diyos. Wala ni gipasagdan sa Ginoo. Kasali ito. Now, look at this. The plan of God for the world is that to put righteousness in it. Maybe the world would commend, oh, simba-simba, wa may makitang tarong sila, ha? Sinabi nila. Sinabi ng mga tao. Pero ang plano ng Diyos, pumunta ang Panginoon dito for us to enjoy the righteousness of God. Ikaw lang ang may sabi na walang righteousness sa atin kasi nga hindi yan maibigay ng tao. Ang makapagbigay ng righteousness, o di God. That's why I said, it will be earned from God, not from anybody. Because in a human view or in human perspective, we are not good actually. We are not good actually. But what we are today is because of the love of God. Tungod sa gugma sa Ginoo, gipakamatarong kita sa Dios. Meron tayong kasalanan, kaya kinuha ng Diyos ang kasalanan. Pagkatapos ikaw sasabihin mo, I'm not righteous. Ngunit ang Diyos nagpakamatay, namatay dito sa cross sa Kalbaryo para mahimo kong righteous. That's included in His plan. That's why He died for you. The Bible says, in 1 Peter chapter 2, nga akong gisulti ganina, that He Himself bore our sin in His body on the tree, that we might die to sin and live for righteousness. Kauban ka sa plano sa Ginoo nga mahimo kang matarong. Look, tingnan mo yung buhay mo noon. Nasa mundo ka. Ang imong kinabuhi, topsy-turvy. Pangit ang dagan sa imong kinabuhi. But because you are included in His plan, now you are sitting there. Nana ka karon. Nilingkod na ka sa sulod sa simbahan. Why? Because you are included in His plan. Next, the plan of God for the world is to put righteousness in it and to execute justice in it. You know, I said, diri sa kalibutan, usahay walay hustisya. Pero sa Ginoo, doon ay hustisya. Hindi mo palang siguro alam ngayon, hindi mo palang na-experience ngayon, pero meron pong hustisya. Meron pong hustisya. Ibig sabihin, if you put one person down, then ang Ginoo, hustisya. Vengeance is not ours, it's God's. Ingon nga, Pastor, gidaog-daog banggod ko karun. Sige lang, Ter. Sige lang, Brad. Hustisya ang Ginoo. Darating at darating din yan. Mabutan na siya. That included in his plan. Maybe wala ni mo ma-enjoy, wala ni mo ma-enjoy ang hustisya karon. But after all, kato mga tao who talk against you, mabot ang panahon, muluhod ragi hapon sila sa imo. Because it was the Lord who bring justice. It was God who execute justice. Look what happened to 20 years in prison. Meron ba siyang kasalanan? Nakita lang niya ang kanyang kaibigan, pinatay. It so happened, pag-abot sa pulis, siya ang nakita dito. Siya gidakop, walay makasulti siya. He was in prison for 20 years. He was in prison for 20 years. Pero, for the period of 20 years in the cell, he encountered Jesus Christ. So what about the policeman? What about those people? Perting mahay sa hustisya. Perting mahay sa judge. Kaya nga naman, nadaot ang ihang pangalan. Nadaot ang bad record. Walay insakto. Mga abogado nadaot. Kaya nga naman, hindi tama ang kanilang desisyon. That's why, that's included in his plan. Maybe you are now experiencing injustices as I've experienced it in my life for so many years, so many times. But one day, muabot ragihapon ang tinuod ng hustisya because God is just. Magpabilin lang kang matinud-anon sa tubangan sa Dios tungod kay hustisya ang Ginoo. Hindi mo lang alam ngayon. Maybe you would enjoy your life today because you putting people down. But one day, muabot ang hustisya sa Ginoo, ikaw lang gihapon mag-suffer. And that's why I would encourage and advise you, don't put people down. Just love them. Just pray for them. And number three, to feel His love in it. And this is the plan of God for the world. Nga puno niya ang kalibutan, siyang gugma. He wants to fill the world with His love. And the Bible tells us, the earth is full of His love, His unfailing love. This is included in His plan. And number four, to fulfill it throughout all generations. Igsoon, ang plano ng tao hanggang sa iyo lang. Pero ang Panginoon, hindi. Ang plano ng Diyos para sa iyo, para sa sunod na henerasyon, para sa sunod pang henerasyon. That's why we are secured in the hands of the Lord because we are included in His plan. Even the next generation. Mawala man ta aning simbahanan eh, dili naman ko pastor aning simbahanan eh, this church is included with God's plan and the God that we are serving would continue to bless this church because this is included in His plan. Ang imong pamilya, apil sa plano sa Ginoo. Apil sa plano sa Ginoo ang imong kinabuhi. Apil sa plano sa Ginoo ang imong negosyo. Apil sa plano sa Ginoo ang imong pamilya. Igsuon, ayaw kabalaka. Kasaylian sa plano ng Diyos. When we say yes to the Lord, and when Pastora Alice give me a two daughters, Julie and Jill, pagdako nila, inakuon, saan na ito pagpa-eskwela sa ilaha, sa kinder, ka-eskwela sila sa kinder. Saan na ito pagpa-eskwela sa ilaha, sa elementary, na humanggi hapon nila elementary. Kung saan na ito pagpa-eskwela sila sa high school, na human nilang high school, kasi ang among allowance kanya, to dili man allowance, alawan ra, gikan sa simbahan. Muhilak mo ang kabaw sa kalisod. Unya, pag-college nila, isamot. But you know what? Walay ni tabang sa mua, mga membro, even a single person, God supported us. And my two daughters enrolled in the university, not in just college, but in the university. Who provided that? It was God. Because my generation is included in God's plan. Muna nga kamong mga igsoon, ayaw mo kabalaka sa inyong future, sa inyong mga anak. Pagpangalagad lang mo tinud-anay, kay kauban sila sa plano sa Dios ang imong mga anak, kasalian sa plano ng Dios. What will happen to us in this world, the Lord is going to destroy this place. The Lord is going to destroy this world But there was a plan of God. Doon na nag-iandam ang Diyos. Balay, lun-lun bulawan dito sa langit. Pagkanindot sa plano si Ginoo. Diba? It was a wonderful and a beautiful plan. That's why I said, God's love is unfailing. Why? Because of the power of His Word. Sinabi niya, totoo yun. And because we are included in His plan. Kaya we are so assured that God loves us so much. And finally, the last. God loves us so much and His love is unfailing because of the purpose of His work. Because of the purpose of His work. According to verse 5, it says here, of verse 8 to 11, I should say, Ingon siya, let all the earth fear the Lord, let the people of the world revere Him. In verse 9, for He spoke and it came to be. He commanded and stood it firm. The Lord foils the plans of the nations. He thwarts the purposes of the peoples. But the plans of the Lord stands firm forever. And at the purposes of His heart through all generation. The purpose of His work, nga nung himo ni sa Dios, is for people to fear Him and revere Him. What do you mean by fear? Igsoon, gihigugma ka sa Dios, andyan yun ang failing love ng Panginoon by His Word, because of the power of His Word, kasali ka sa plano ng Diyos, dahil gusto ng Diyos, hindi na tayo gagawa ng masasama. Fear the Lord means, di tamuhimog dautan. And revere Him. Siya lang ang atong daigon. Siya lang ang atong simbahon. Siya lang ang atong alagaran. That's the reason why He expresses love to you, because He wants you to be good. He wants you to revere Him. Siya lang ang atong alagaran. And that's the reason why He loves us. That's the purpose of His work. Gihimo niyang tanan, even dying on the cross, so that people will fear Him and revere Him. Second is this, to foil the plan of the nation. Ginawa ng Diyos ang kanyang totoong pag-ibig sa atin by His Word and by His plan for the world and by His purpose. And this is the purpose of His work. To foil the plan of the nation, not people, and not nation as country, pero sa mga tao. What do you mean by foil? Foil is just a metal na siya, and just like something like to prevent. But the meaning that in the New King James Version tells us about for nothing. Ibig sabihin, gihimo sa Dios ang insaktong plano para sa tua, na ang word sa Dios, ang katuyuan ani is that ang masasamang plano ng mga tao sa atin is just nothing. Walay mahimo ang plano sa mga tao against us. If other people wants to destroy us, they will not prosper. They will not prosper. This is the purpose of His work. That's why we are covered by His blood, by His love. Nganuman, for the plan of the people against us will not prosper. Dili sila mag-prosper. Ang plano sa mga tao against you to put you down, dili sa mag-prosper. That even I myself, I am so much confident to God. Because He loves me, and people would just look at me, people would just talk against me, I'm not afraid of it. Why? Because God is going to foil the plan of the people. Meaning, it's just nothing. Wala na, di na mag-prosper, di na mauswag. Thirdly, to thwart the purpose of the people. Usabot pasabot sa thwart. No effect. The purpose, no effect ang ilang katuyuan. Para sa imuha. Because He loves you. He loves me. And the purpose of the people to put us down, it's nothing. No effect. Because God will take care of us. Na ang Diyos nga mutabang sa tua. To thwart the purpose of the people against us. Maybe people would just curse us. Tungluhon ta sa Dios sa mga tao. Galit ang mga tao sa iyo. Dahil meron kang sinabi, oh, they will not prosper. Why? Because that's the purpose why he loves you and why he loves me. Muna hinungdan nga nung gihigugmata sa Dios. That's the purpose of his work, dying on the cross to thwart the purpose of the people against us. Meaning, it's no effect. Wala lang na siya. Then, finally, to put into realization his plan and purpose from generation to all generation to generation. Panayin ko na ako gina, as I've said, ayaw kabalaka sa imong mga anak. Ayaw kabalaka sa imong pamilya. Because surely God loves you. God loves your family. Ayaw kabalaka sa imong mga anak. Mga human na sila. Siguro imong anak bugoy-bugoy lang na karon. Hindi mo lang alam, kinabukasan magiging pastor din yun. Yun ang nangyari sa akin. I've been in the world. But because my parents, they are faithful. Faithful ang ako maginikanan sa pagpangalagad sa Dios. Sila ang naningkamot na makahimog Foursquare Church dito sa among dapit. Bisag na bugoy ko, God is in control. God is in control. I was then black sheep in our family. But brothers and sisters in the Lord, He changed my life. He changed my life because I was then included in His plan. And that the purpose of God for doing this is not only for my parents, but even for the next generation. And so, I enjoyed it. My children, they are not good man siguro, di man po kumayo po siguro, but my family are now joining me in the ministry. That even my daughter in America, they are in the ministry. That even my apo, they are really serving the Lord faithfully. Dili basta-basta from generation mo na nga dita mabalaka sa atong pamilya. Darating at darating din ang panahon kasi gagawin ng Diyos ang kanya mga plano para sa atin. Kasi mahal ka ng Diyos. Amen? Gihigugmata sa Diyos kaya hindi na yan niya pwedeng iwanan tayo. And as I end up, His love is unfailing that lasts throughout all generations of the world. That's what I said. Magkinaon sa managdagan sa kalibutan mga igsoon, dili gid ka pasagdan sa Ginoo. Even the next generation, hindi ka pababayaan ng Diyos. And His unfailing love, dili lang dire. His unfailing love brings us to eternity. Igsoon, magkinaon sa man ang dagan sa atong kinabuhi. Dire sa kalibutan, i-bless sa Ginoo ang atong henerasyon. Pero sultian ko ikaw, dili lamang ang atong henerasyon diri sa kalibutan, pero tungod sa gugma sa Dios, God prepared a better place for all of us. And so you, every one of us, apil ka sa plano sa Dios, o kitang tanan mo ato sa dapit, nga giandam niya, tungod kay mahal kita sa Dios. And He said, for God so loved the world, that He gave His only Son, that whosoever believes in Him, so not what? Perish, but have everlasting life. Igsoon, that's eternity. Munang eternity. Munang salamat na sa Ginoo sa iyang pagkamaayo sa tuwa. Amen? Hallelujah. A clap offering to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Thank you, Lord. Let's pray. Eternal God, we thank you for loving us. And sometimes, Lord, we are not worthy to enjoy that love, to enjoy your love. But it is you, Lord, who decided to love us. And we are so thankful, Lord, for that. For your love is unconditional. People would initiate love unconditional. People would, Lord God, love with condition. But we thank you because when you love us, it's unconditioned. With no condition. And thank you so much, Lord, for that. So today, we are so thankful, Lord, for your great love. That sometimes we are not good. Sometimes, Lord, we are not faithful. But we thank you because you remain faithful to us, because you love us. And so, Lord, today, we just want to say thank you for reminding us that you love us so much. And your love is unfailing. We give you thanks, Lord, for that. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Magatindog kitang tanan. Ang Diyos nakabalo sa tanan nimong sitwasyon karon. Alam ng Diyos kung anong sitwasyon meron ka ngayon. Kung masaya ka, alam ng Diyos. Kung meron kang problema, alam ng Diyos. Kung magulanon ka, kabalo ang Diyos na inintanan. Kung nakay kabugaton, kabalo tanan ng Diyos. Walay nalilong sa tubangan sa Diyos. He keep on watching over us. Gibantayan ta niya 24 hours. Dili ka man siguro nabantayan sa imong ginikanan, di ka man siguro nabantayan sa imong bana, sa imong asawa, pero ang atong Ginoo nga nasa langit, gibantayan ka niya 24 hours. He will not sleep. He will not slumber. Gibantayan ka niya. You're just like a baby. Nadia, naghigda ka. Gibantayan ka sa imong inahan. Gibantayan ka sa imong papa when you were a baby. Ingana ka kamahal sa Ginoo. Kabalo siya sa imong sitwasyon karon. Mga pastor, dami kong problema, daming struggles. Kapatid, ilagay mo sa sarisa, isipan mo, ilagay mo sa puso mo. Mahal na mahal ka ng Diyos. Hindi at hindi kanya pababayaan. Muna nga karoon buntaga, watay laing atuan, kundili muduol tanga do sa Diyos. Kumingon tanga, Lord, Ginoo, ayaw in tami pasagdi, Ginoo. Ayaw mi pasagdi, Lord. Kabalumi nga higugma ka na mo, Ginoo. Please don't leave us, Lord. Ayaw in taon mi pasagdi, Ginoo. Bantay in taon mi, Lord. Bantay mi, Lord. So karon kabuntagon, kining awit nga nagingon, draw me close to you. The chorus says, you're all I want. Wamantay laing matuan, ang Ginoo ra gyud ang atong sandiganan. Amen? Let's sing that song. Draw me close to you. Never let me go. I lay it all down again to hear you say that I'm your friend. You are my desire. No one else will do. There's nothing else could take your place to feel the warm of your embrace. Help me find a way. Bring me back to you. And declare it. You're all I want, Lord. More than anything else in this world. You're all I want. Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, Lord. You're all I want. This time I said, because God loves you. Amen. Can you say amen to that? Kung kay gihigugma ka sa Dios, ang Dios mag-aayos sa imong mga balatian. Ang Dios mag-supply sa imong mga pagkinahanglan. Ang Dios mag-solve sa imong mga problema with His help. Don't be bothered. Don't be bothered. Don't be bothered because He loves you so much. kung dunay kabugaton ay kabalaka, naa ang Diyos nga nahigugma kanimo. Mo na Diyos nga atong gilagaran diri sa Living Temple. Let's sing that song. Draw me close to you. Yes, Lord. It is our design, Father God.
Never let me go. Lay it all down again. To hear you say that I'm your friend.
Yes, Lord,
you are my
desire.
No one else will do.
Just nothing else could take your place
to feel the warmth of your embrace.
Lord,
help me find a way. Bring me back.
Now lift up your hands. Lift up your hands into the Lord and sing it.
You're all I want.
Jesus is His name. He is Jesus.
You're all.
Oh yes, Lord. Glory to God. Oh yes, Lord. You're all. Sing it one more time. You're all I want.
You're all I want. You're all I am. You're all I want. Happy.
Yes, Lord, we thank you for your love for us, Lord, through your Son, Jesus Christ. Oh, we bless you, Lord. We give you thanks, Lord, for your love for us. You're so faithful, Lord. We thank you so much for your unfailing love. We thank you so much, Lord, for your unfailing love, Lord. Oh, we are so assured. We are so confident, Lord. We are so confident and we are so sure because we know that you love us. Oh, God, thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. We will not be worried, Lord. Wala kami kamalaka because of your love. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, we give you thanks, Lord. We love. Hallelujah. 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 Just thank Him. Just thank Him. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. Praise God. And today, people of the Lord, because of His great love for you, I'd like to pray in the name of Jesus. Tungod kay ikaw na higugma sa imong mga kanakan, karun kabuntagon, katong dunay mga balatian, imo na silang giayo. Salamat sa imong gugma, Ginoo. Hallelujah. We thank you so much, Lord, for your healing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Katong dunay mga problema, muli sila Ginoo nga dunay kadaugan. Imo na kita bangat sa pagsulbad din mga problema sa ilang pamilya. And we thank you so much, Father God, for that deliverance. Oh Lord, we thank you so much, Father God, for your love for us. And so Lord, we thank you even for providing all our needs from generation to generation. Hallelujah. We will not be worried, Lord. We will not be worried, Lord, with our future. Because you're in control of everything. We are included of your plan. We are included, dear Ginoo. Salamat tungod kay appeal dia ikan sa imong mga plano, Ginoo. And so we are so thankful, Lord, to that. Oh, we bless you, we honor you. Hallelujah. Lord, akong gideklarar ang kaayuhan sa mga katawhan nga dunay mga balatian karon. Even for those who are watching and listening. Lord, thank you so much for your healing touch, Lord, for everyone. And Lord, we thank you so much, Father God, for the solution to every problem. And we thank you so much, Father God, for those people who are now, Lord, suffering with, Lord, DUI, o kung ano sa man ginoong mga virus na sila mga kalawasan. Sa ngalan ni Jesus, Lord, set them free. We thank you so much, Father God, even as you begin to open the gates of heaven and pour out your hundredfold of blessings for everyone. Lord, in the name of Jesus, with the authority of your name, I speak healing today in the name of Jesus. I speak deliverance. I speak blessings for everyone. Hallelujah. Dega, pasalamat ang Diyos. Pasalamat ang Diyos. Yes, Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. What a beautiful God we serve. Amen. Pagkamayo sa Ginoo. He loves us so much. Thank you, Lord. Magapamauli kami karon, Ginoo, dala ang kadaugan, dala ang kalipay. Tungod kinabati na mo, you have reminded us that you love us so much. And that many times, Lord, we have a lot of questions at the back of our minds if you really love us. But we thank you today. You have reminded us that you love us. Because you said it. You said it, Lord. And because we are included of your plan. And you made a lot of work for us to be loved by you. That even, Father God, we are in darkness, you have rescued us and put us into the light. Lord, we thank you for all the blessings that we received today, even the joy in serving you. And as we go home, Lord, cover each one of us, Lord, in your precious blood. Lord, protected from any virus in the name of Jesus. Covered by the precious blood of Jesus. Lord, our families, our loved ones, Lord, will always be protected from any virus in Jesus' name. And you would cover each one of us, Lord, with your precious blood. And we give you thanks, Lord, and praise, Lord, for that. And even, Father God, facing another days of this coming week, put each one of us, Lord, into the hollow of your hands. Protected, provided, O Lord, even guided by your Spirit. We give you thanks even for blessing those who are watching their live streaming and for those who are listening, Lord, to radio station. And even for everyone inside of this building, inside of this sanctuary, I speak, Lord, special favor for everyone. I speak special favor for everyone. Tanan, Ginoo, nininga sanctuaryo, bisan pa diha sa gawas. I pray for blessing everyone. In the name of Jesus. Ug salamat, Ginoo, sa ilahang gugma kanimo pagbalik. Yani asla karon, they are preparing, O Lord, their offerings and bringing their tithes because of their love to you. For they know that you are the God who will provide all their needs. So bless each one of us. And we thank you. Bring each one of us home safe. We give you thanks and praise and the glory. And may the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will always guard our hearts and minds. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And people of God would say, Amen. Once again, a clap offering to the Lord, to the King. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Kaway-kaway mo sa inyong mga katapad. And thank you so much for coming. And for those who are watching, may the Lord God bless you. God bless us all. Bye-bye.